I need to assess their personality so that I know what to expect from them, so that I know what I can expect from them and I won't get disappointed. Therefore, I need to assess. But I don't need to assess you or judge you to put you in a category of good or bad, to put you in a category of I like you, I don't like you.
Where it is necessary,
you're not judging the person, like I said, to fix them in a category. You're just judging why, to understand what to expect and what can be safely expected from a person without disappointment. So if I know, for example, that this mic makes awaj beech mein, I have to expect it is going to make awaj beech mein rather than get annoyed at it. Now what am I doing? I'm assessing the nature of this instrument, and therefore I expect in such a way that I don't get agitated when this happens, because I know it could. So if I'm dealing with a person who has an anger issue, I have to expect ki kabhi bhi sanak jayega, possible hai. I have to expect it. If I expect it, I'm ready in terms of how to deal with it. That's why I will assess personalities. I don't like to use the word judge. I mean, who are you to judge? Yeah. Awareness. I completely agree with that.
Avoid.
Okay. You can avoid. Of course you can avoid. And therefore you assess and you understand this is what I can deal with, this is what I don't want to deal with. That's okay. There's another theory in psychology, again to do with your own personality. Remember those personality stressors? They say that people who are very anxious by nature, and some people just have that anxious nature, you know, there's nothing particular that happened, but they're just constantly anxious. So if you came late, they're anxious. If you came early, they're anxious. They don't need a reason, they're just anxious. Now why does that happen? One thing is that, now this is just a psychological theory which says, say this is your personality. Hypothetically, it's just a theory. Say this is your personality. Conscious is this little bit over here. That's all you're aware of, they say. And they say there's so much within you which you have no clue. You really don't know what's going on within. Does it ever happen sometimes that you said something but you didn't actually mean to say it? And you'll be like, I don't know, wo kidhar se nikal gaya, I didn't mean it. Did that ever happen to anyone?
Yeah.
Happens? Where did it come from? Yeah. Psychologists say it's coming from here. Stuff that you've pushed in. So, what is the connection to anxiety? They say that whatever past painful experiences that you have gone through, experiences that have hurt you, that have made you feel sad, that have made you feel helpless, hopeless, whatever. It could be childhood issues, it could be beyond that, whatever, traumas, anything that you find unacceptable or difficult to deal with is going to be pushed down. Pushed down means, you know how sometimes we push things under the carpet? We don't want to deal with it. Baad mein dekhenge. Everything that you push down stays within you. And they say that whatever stays within you is still inside you, no? Abhi, you know, like children do that when they don't want to eat. One chapati ka tukda you will find under the carpet. What happens to that chapati ka tukda? It disappears? No, it rots. That's exactly what happens with stuff inside you. It accumulates and it harasses you. So one explanation of anxiety is there are lots of things that you have suppressed. It could be past hurt, something that someone said to you, little things, but they pile up and they create, you know, havoc here. And sooner or later, they're going to come out in some form. Sometimes it's anger outbursts. Sometimes it's crying spells. And you don't know why you're crying, huh? It can happen. Sometimes it's just general anxiousness, worries. You start worrying about anything and everything, and even you feel, why am I doing this? But it could happen because of this too. And of course, worries can be learned. Can you learn how to worry from someone? Yeah?
Yes.
How?
Based on this, my child will learn from parents.
Yes. Say if my... True, you're absolutely right. Say if my mother was scared of dogs, and say, while I was a kid, there was a dog that entered the room, and because she had to protect me, she might have just pulled me and shooed away the dog. Okay, but while she's holding me, what is the grip like? When she's holding me, what is the grip like, Dheela? Tight. What does the child understand? That dog is something that needs to be feared. Why? Because my mother fears it. So I should fear it too. Similarly, say financial worries or whatever it is that we may face as problems at home. As parents, grandparents, if we react with worry, people around us may follow suit. They may imitate us. They are learning, okay, this is how you deal with this. So worries can be learned, fears can be learned. In fact, in psychology, they did a highly unethical experiment where they wanted to show that fears can be learned. They took a little child, around 9 to 11 months, and put him in a room, okay? And he was a very playful child, never feared anything, like except for these loud bang noises, which most kids are scared of. But didn't fear anything else. They made him play with various things, toys and this and that. Then they made him play with one white furry rat. He was very fond of it, nicely played with it, no issue. Then the hypothesis was, we will teach this child to fear that white rat. You think it's possible?
Yes.
Possible? She's saying it's possible. What do you all think?
Yes.
It is possible, unfortunately. What did they do? Anything. Now, they taught that child to fear white furry rats. How? You know, the child is here. The rat was sent into the room. The child would like to play with that rat, so he reached out. Every time the child reached out to play with that rat, they had this metal plate at the far end of that room, and they would just hit that plate really loud. So there was a loud bang metal sound. Now, for a child of 9 to 11 months, is that scary? Of course it is, right? So every time the child tried to reach that white furry rat, there would be that bang sound and the child would get startled. Slowly, after around 5-6 trials like that, same thing would happen. After around 5-6 trials, there was a change that they noticed in the child. Every time the rat just came in, the child would start getting scared and start crying. What is happening here? This is what we call conditioning, learning. What did the child learn?
Fear of the rat.
How?
Something unpleasant.
Yeah. Now, what did the child do? The child was smart. The child realized every time the rat comes in, what also comes with it?
Noise.
That noise. So he learned to anticipate the noise every time he saw the rat. Right? Now when that happens, the moment he sees the rat, he starts crying. This is how fears can be learned. You understand? All of us can learn certain fears because of this pairing. Say you went for swimming and the coach just pushed you off the diving board. You got so scared you never went back. Why? You associated swimming with the fear that you experienced while the coach pushed you. Possible. These associations are very difficult to break, and therefore a lot of fears just last. So that's about conditioning. Now, unfortunately, what also happened to this child, he didn't only get scared of white furry rats, he also got scared of everything that was white and furry. He generalized the fear. So what else is white and furry?
Cats.
Good. Dogs. What else?
Rabbits,
Daddy, Santa Claus. He started getting scared of even candy floss. Started getting scared of even that. That's how fears can get generalized. Happens. Say if someone lost someone in an air crash, I could get scared of flights after that. Possible? Yeah. Why am I getting scared of subsequent flights? That flight crashed. But I'm generalizing it to all flights. That's how fears are maintained and built. Now, I've learned to fear a particular thing. Say I've learned to fear flights. Okay? A lot of people can't take a flight. They have a phobia. See, if I learn to fear of light, how will I overcome it? What is the best way to overcome it? By flying. Face it, absolutely right. But most people, what will they do? Avoid. Your technique. They'll avoid it. So then what will happen? The fear gets maintained. It doesn't have a chance to go only because you have never changed this association. You know, this negative association you need to change. So with flying, if I have a negative association of crash, I have to change this by, if I keep on flying, I'm going to have an association which is pleasant. But I have to keep flying to get that pleasant association. How else will that happen? So the technique is, of course, to face the fear.
Ma'am, I have a question here.
Yes, please.
According to what you have told us, it means that your behavior is directly linked to your upbringing. Your childhood upbringing is very much responsible for your behavior.
Sigmund Freud would love you. Sigmund Freud is a psychologist who says exactly what you're saying.
No, my question is, but all that has been come during a course of time, lot of years have passed.
Yes.
So how can we change it instantly or in a short term life?
There's no instant fix, but you have to at least start.
But is it possible that
of course,
whatever you have been trained in your childhood, that upbringing, can we change that personality of
yours? Okay. Now his question is that, could everyone hear what he said?
Yeah.
He's saying a lot of your childhood upbringing is going to have an impact of who you are today. Would you agree? Can it have an impact? Yeah, and mostly it does. Now he's saying, how do you change that? By the way, we're also very selective in our learning, all of us. What we pick up from our childhood upbringing, what we pick up from our parents is very selective. How many of our parents said, beta, go out and drink? Did any of your parents say that? Did they say, beta, you should go out and smoke? Very good for you. Did they ever say that? Are yes or no? I'm not going to tell your parents, don't worry. The point is, did you ever try it?
Yes.
Yeah, and some may be continuing, but did you ever try a cigarette? Yes or no?
Yes.
Did you ever taste alcohol?
Yes.
Parents told you to? Eh? No, asking.
No.
Parents told you to?
It depends on family.
One sec. I'm just saying, parents teach us a lot of things. How come we pick up what is convenient to us? We don't pick up everything. Parents say early to bed, early to rise. Right?